Hello. As you probably know, when you get level 50, you have all perks available to build your character. Leveling up further will permit you to open perks you still don't have. Also, you can move special points around, one per level up, to be able to use certain perks you are interested in. You may know what it's all about, or maybe you are a newbie in the game. I will cover up everything you should to know about builds. So when you start your first character, you obviously don't know what's going on. It is not the same mechanic you saw in Fallout 4. Normally players try everything, and this is perfect. Despite of anyone who suggests you to use only rifles, or only heavies, and never grenade launchers, because they suck. No matter what they say, try everything you have good feelings about. Anyway, you can change everything about your character, or create another one. The first character you can convert in a mule. And believe me, from certain point you will need one. There you will equip all weight reduction perks and stuff him with everything you want. So how to build your character? Step by step. First step. You will need to get level 50. If you play only 2 hours on Sunday, try to play 2 more when double XP weekend comes up. And do all events you see on the map. Second. You have to earn some caps. Sell cheap in your vendors, whatever you don't need. Third step. When you finally got level 50 and have some caps, dedicate yourself to do some shopping, store your junk, equip travel agent, and visit all camps where you see weapons on sale. Never overpay more than 3-4k for okay rolls and 6-10k for very good rolls. The next step. On your way to level 50, collect some scripts to spend them in a rusty pick. There is a limit of 1k scripts, so keep in mind that. Whenever you get level 50, spend all of them on 3-star legendary armor. In the future, you will replace all your pieces for better ones, and it will take you forever. Of course, you can get a good legendary loot from drops, and this is how the game works. Kill, loot, replace, sell what has been replaced, or scrap it. Next step. You can choose between go full health or low health. The best armor for full health is Vanguard, and Unyielding for low health builds. Or you can use power armor, the best option for heavy weapons. Next step, mutations. Well, mutations are not optional, you must use them to be more efficient. Period. Next step, addictions. If you are addicted to chems or boosts, your junkies weapons do up to 50% more damage. It goes 10% per one addiction you have. As well, you can addict yourself to medics and psycho to be able to use some armor with the berserker build. But it is under power build for now, not recommended. For any type of fighter build, you need to max your strength or perception. In this case, maxed would be between 12 and 15 special points. In case of pistols builds, you actually need to max your agility, but it is another story. As well, you can choose between being more tanky or sneaky. To be able to tank more damage, it's better to put more points in endurance. Or you can max your agility, if you want to deal sneak attacks all the time. You can build your character based on what's criticals as well. There you will need to max your luck. Or if you play with a team, you can max your charisma to be able to share up to 5 perk cards. And finally, we have legendary perks that help make us more versatile. Be sneaky and tanky at the same time, use all type of weapons or just do more damage with current one. So a build in Fallout 76 is a combo of weapon you use, set of armor you have, mutations or addictions you contracted, and perks you will change depending on situation and gear you use. Okay, blooded heavy power armor build for level 300 something. Two weapons, primary, and another one for boss fights. This is not explosive, just heavy gun. So, best rolls possible. Okay, armor. It's a power armor with mods, emergency protocols for torso and calibrated shocks for legs. Mutations. I think it's all clear here. This one is very important to land smoothly. This one, adrenal reaction because we go bloated, carry weight. I think. Everything is clear here. Addiction, no addictions. Because we go only blooded. Okay, and perks. everything from heavies, damage, defensive. This one is very important actually. So one stat, travel pharmacy, a little bit foodie, but we have three legendary strength for this level, so why not? To deal more damage with close sight, to deal more damage against growing ones. This one, power armor plus fireproof, no damage from explosions, zero. To be more tanky, radical, why not? We can. Tenderizer, more damage. Then wanderer, this will solo everything. And this one is very, very powerful actually. Suppressor is defensive, take less damage. Stabilizer damage, Neurot Rage damage, Demolition Expert damage for our explosive weapons, but we can exchange this one. Dodge defense to tank more damage, and we have crazy action points regenerate actually, very crazy with all of this. Adrenaline damage, here. Bundle starch jeans and class freak, bloody mass damage, and one guy army, and this one to cripple, let's say. Okay, legendary perks, defense very, very powerful actually. This one is the only one that every power armor user needs. Okay, we boost endurance as maximum as possible. Agility, yeah, for adrenaline, luck for class freak, and this one is free.